Hey guys, I'm Nisha Homi. Today I'm sharing Arbi roast recipe. Arbi is also known as Taru, Colocasia and Chamber in Malayalam. It's a seasonal root vegetable and it is a good source of resistant starch. This Arbi roast is an everyday sabji which goes well with rice or with roti. So without wasting much time, let's get started with the recipe. To make Arbi roast, I have sliced Arbi into thin strips like this. So this is 300 grams of Arbi. So this is the size of the Arbi, and what I did was I just peeled off the skin with the potato peeler. Arbi is a good source of resistant starch, hence it is ideal for those with health issues like diabetes. So once the skin is peeled, removing the top and bottom portion, and I'm going to wash and rinse it thoroughly. And once it is washed and rinsed thoroughly, just slice into small strips. Always try to include seasonal grains, vegetables and fruits in your diet so that you can get a wide variety of nutrients in your diet. Now you need to wash and rinse this a couple of times or until the water runs clear. I'm using a handful of shallots. I prefer to use shallots in my recipes as they are a rich source of iron and folate. However, if you don't have access to shallots, you can use half of an onion instead. So I'm going to thinly slice the shallots. Heat a wide pan or a kadai with 1.5 tablespoon of wood pressed coconut oil. Now instead of wood pressed coconut oil, you can use any locally sourced wood pressed oil of your choice. Remember that wood pressed oils has a neutral flavor and taste. Healthy cooking is all about using the right quality of oil. Try to include wood pressed oils in your meals and try to avoid refined oils. So once the oil is heated, I'm adding in the sliced shallots. Add in some curry leaves. Reduce the flame to the lowest, and once the shallots starts to turn light golden brown, add in 1 tablespoon Kashmiri chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon turmeric powder. Give it a mix and allow it to saute in the oil for about 30 to 40 seconds so that the raw flavor of the chili powder is diminished. And then add in the washed and rinsed sliced Arbi. Add in pink Himalayan salt as needed and give it a nice mix. Mix it really well. I want the Arbi to be coated with the masala. Add in 1/4 cup water, stir it again, cover and let it cook on medium flame. After about 2 minutes, open the lid and give it a stir, cover and let it cook on low flame. After 5 minutes, let's check on the Arbi, and you can see that the water has almost evaporated, the Arbi is almost cooked. I'm just seeing whether the Arbi is cooked. Okay, the Arbi is cooked. So I'm not going to cover it again. I'm going to roast this without covering. So you need to stir on and off just to make sure that the Arbi does not stick to the bottom of the pan. I'm just spreading out the Arbi and lightly roasting it. After every 1.5 to 2 minutes, just stir the Arbi. This is just to make sure that it is not getting stick to the bottom of the pan, and then spread it out so that it gets roasted really well. Another 2 minutes later, stir it really well. Spread it out and allow it to roast. So you need to do this process about 3 to 4 times or until the Arbi is nicely roasted. And 10 minutes later, the arbi is nicely roasted, as you can see, and it's ready to serve. So I'm going to turn off the flame, and you can see that the arbi is nicely coated with the masala and it is roasted really well. Transfer to a plate. You can enjoy this with rice or with roti. A very simple everyday side dish. So guys, do try this recipe and let me know how it turned out. Also, comment below and let me know which is your favorite arbi recipe. Thank you for watching, and until next time, take care. Bye-bye.